Let's now go through the exercise together and see how you could have done it. So first, we're asked to build a PyVision display with some values and some symbols. So as always, we'll make sure that we are using our mixing tank 1. And it's not necessarily because we only want to do the mixing tank 1, because as we've seen, because they're using templates, the one display that we do will be able to be applied to all of our tanks. So I'm now mixing tank 1. The first thing I want to have is the asset name, which makes a lot of sense, especially when we're going to change the display from one tank to the other one. You'll want to make sure that the person who's looking at the display knows what asset they're looking at. So for the asset name, there's not really a need to have the timestamp, so we'll remove what we don't need. Okay, great start. We now have the value of our asset name. We now want to add a graphic for our tank. Okay, great, and I have a graphic for my tank. So I'm browsing back to the assets, and we want to get a value for the external temperature. So in this case, I'm not going to display the timestamp, but you can decide what you want to display. And there's also many ways you can have the label. So in my case, because we already have the asset name on the display, then let's simply put the external temperature. We now want to add a gauge for the internal temperature. So once more, I always select my symbol first, and then I simply drag and drop. So here we can see there's many different things that we can do to format it the way we want. What I'm mostly interested in here is the label. And then I can change if I want it on top, at the bottom, can change the scale. By default, it will use the scale that is defined in the AF attribute. So the last thing we want for this step is to have a trend. And the trend will be for both temperatures. So notice that here I select both temperatures before doing the drag and drop. But you could have also done it twice, do drag and drop for one, and then drop the temperature for the other one. So the last thing we'll want to do is add an asset comparison table. So in the asset comparison table, we want the installation date and the asset location. So the asset comparison table is really great for a lot of static attributes to be able to compare what tank am I looking at and what does it contain. So here I'm going to look at all my tanks. Okay, so the last thing we want to do is add a multi-state. So adding the multi-state will allow us to quickly see for what tanks is the external temperature too high and that we may need to provide something to the asset. So in this case, let's say this is a critical temperature, then let's add it in red so we can quickly see what's going on. We'll leave the default, but feel free to change any of the limits. So great, now we've done it for mixing tank 1. Well, I may be interested here in creating a collection. So I can just quickly select all the symbols I want and convert it to a collection. So once more, let's make sure that we are searching in the entire production area. But think about, for your plant, you may want to only look at one production line or one specific area. So you will not always want to put the root as the root of your AF. Because if we look again on our structure, we'll search everything below the search root that we select. In this case, I already have the template selected, and I'll want to get for all of them that the external temperature is greater than 150. Okay, fantastic. Now let's just expand this to be able to see all our assets. So now I'm getting a quick overview, and as we can see, the external temperature is greater than 140 for all my tanks, and therefore I'm visualizing all four of my tanks here. So I was asking in the exercise to know how many tanks were overheated at 8 a.m. this morning. So we can simply go here and change the end time. So what will be displayed other than the trends for the values and gauges, it will always be the end time of your display. So therefore, if we want 8 a.m., we can do T plus 8H. So we can see that in this case, three of the tanks this morning were overheated. And we can also know the temperatures. So we would probably want to take a look at storage tank 2 first, and then maybe mixing tank 2. The other question asks how many tanks were overheated at noon yesterday. So same thing, we'll go look at noon yesterday. Well, in this case, we can see all three tanks that were overheated at noon yesterday. And also, because we added a multi-state, we can see that we want to prioritize looking at mixing tank 1 and storage tank 2. So once you're completed with the exercise and you're satisfied with your display, feel free to add more graphics, add more multi-state, and think about how you could apply that on your plant. And simply save the display and give it a meaningful name. Perfect, so I now have my display, it is saved, and I'm very satisfied with it. So we'll now move to the next exercise where we'll use those concepts again.